I know a lot of us are outraged. We're dismayed. We're discouraged. Because any one of us could have been Trayvon Martin. And any one of us could have been taken away from our families from such a senseless act of racially driven violence. We've all experienced violence in this city, but the racially driven violence cuts to the core. And I want to I just want to straighten out a few myths, some legal myths that we've all heard throughout this case. In Florida, they have a law called Stand Your Ground. They sometimes call it the Make My Day law, in a tribute to the old Clint Eastwood movie, Sudden Impact. And they're telling people across the world that the Stand Your Ground law was used to justify the killing of Trayvon Martin. And I'm here to tell you all today, that is a lie.
That's right.
I took the opportunity to research Florida's Stand Your Ground law.
That's not a lie.
And what I found was that it does not apply to Trayvon Martin. Let me tell you the reasons why. First of all, with Stand Your Ground, the law tells a person to stand their ground, not to pursue, not to stalk, not to engage in confrontation that leads to violence. The reason why the Stand Your Ground law does not apply for a legal basis is because the law states that in order to enjoy the benefits of Florida's Stand Your Ground law, you must not be engaged in illegal activity and you must be attacked. It goes again, it's not or, it's not one or the other, it's both. You must not be engaged in legal activity and you must be attacked. Now why does that apply to this case? Because George Zimmerman was following, harassing, and stalking Trayvon Martin. Stalking is a crime in the state of Maryland. But not only in the state of Maryland, Florida has a statute that speaks to stalking directly. It is a crime in the state of Florida to stalk an individual. It is a felony in the state of Florida to stalk an individual with a credible threat of violence that places that individual in reasonable fear. Why is that important in this case? That's important because George Zimmerman was a 200-pound man charging, pursuing, stalking, hunting a 140-pound young teenage boy. That to me is a credible threat that would place someone in reasonable fear of death or serious bodily injury. And that constitutes the element of felony stalking. Now, once you've established that the law of stalking has been violated, and he violated not only by stalking Trayvon Martin in a car, but he got out of his car and stalked him on foot. So not only was he being stalked in a vehicle, but also on foot. Now, the beautiful thing about the Florida's law dealing with stalking is that police expressly by the law have the right to arrest without a warrant. The police have the right, as it's written in the statute says the police have the right to arrest without a warrant.
That's right.
So they don't have to ask anybody's for permission. Anybody. That's right. The stalking allegation doesn't even have to be corroborated. Someone could call on the phone and say, I'm being stalked.
Yeah.
And if it's a credible call, and the police believe that that's enough to constitute probable cause, and normally it is in normal circumstances, the police can go out and make that arrest. Now, the reason why Trayvon Martin's killer has not been arrested is because they don't want to. It's because they don't want to. Plain and simple, it has nothing to do with stand your ground because that law doesn't apply. It has nothing to do with self-defense. In fact, the person who would be entitled to the stand your ground law as written is Trayvon Martin. And that's not Jay Wyndal, the lawyer talking. That's what the law says in the state of Florida. You can look that up. I think it's 776.048. You can look that up. So, do not be confused. Do not be tricked into believing that there is a legitimate reason why Zimmerman has not been arrested. Because there are none.
That's right, boy.
That's right.
But let me tell you this.
What can we do about it?
We have George Zimmerman's in the state of Maryland.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wow. George Zimmerman in the state of Florida is a representation of racism in America.
That's right.
He is the personification of racial profiling, of murder because of the color of your skin. It has nothing to do with a hoodie because George Zimmerman had on a red jacket. Now, we should be more afraid of that red jacket because that red jacket is what caused us harm. It wasn't a hoodie. It wasn't some Skittles or iced tea. So I just want you all to be clear and thank you for listening to me under the sound of my voice. And if I may do a plug, we will be discussing this further tomorrow on my radio show. Actually, the Monumental City Bar Association's radio show. I'm president of the Monumental City Bar. That's about 300 lawyers, African-American minority lawyers in the Baltimore region. It was founded in 1935 in part by the Honorable Thurgood Marshall. We have a radio show that airs every Tuesday on WOLB 1010 AM. And tomorrow, we will be discussing Trayvon Martin, Stand Your Ground, the Sanford City Police Department, and everything else. We're going to have Billy Murphy. He will be with us tomorrow by way of telephone. We're going to have Craig Thompson, Pastor Heber Brown, myself, Allison Valais Lane, and we're going to have a host of others. So I want you all to listen in because not only will you be enlightened here, but you will be enlightened by what we have to say tomorrow.
What time? What
2 o'clock. 2 o'clock, between 2 and 3 o'clock tomorrow. WOLB 1010, Power of Attorney.